Hello, this is James Pickles, Fasten Savetti product owner. In this video, I'm going to explain how to construct a radiation exposure time exceedance curve from Savetti results. In Savetti, we can produce radiation exceedance curves like the one shown, but they don't tell us anything about the exposure times. And often when it comes to making decisions regarding potential fire scenarios, we need to think about the duration of the fires as well. So to generate these curves, we actually have to extract some information from Savetti and then construct the curves manually within Microsoft Excel. So to do that, we go to the Home tab and we go to the Risk Gallery and choose the Fire Details report. And this report gives us a breakdown of all of the scenarios that cause effects at the various risk ranking points within the study. So we can export this report to Excel. And then once you've exported it to Excel, we can see in this report, we have a column giving us the risk ranking points in the study. We also have the scenarios that contribute to effects at those risk ranking points. For each scenario, we have the outcome frequency, we have the thermal radiation level at the risk ranking point from each scenario, and we also have the duration as well, which is the duration of the thermal radiation level at this point from each of the scenarios. So we can use a combination of the radiation level, the outcome frequency and the duration to give us radiation exposure time exceedance curves. So what I can do within this spreadsheet is I can choose a thermal radiation level of interest. So for example, 37.5 kilowatts per square meter. And then let's say I'm also interested in the effects at the control room within this study. And then what we can do is we need to create a table of exposure times of interest and also exceedance frequencies. So in one column, we will have the exposure time in seconds. And then in another column, we will have the exceedance frequency for the exposure time. And then in the exposure time column, we will enter some exposure times of interest. So we'll start at 1 second, going up to 10 seconds. And then from 10 seconds, we will go up to 100 seconds in 10 second increments. And then from there, we'll go up to 200 seconds, 300, 400, 500. Then we'll go to 1,000. And then 2,000, 3,000, and then the maximum exposure time within Savetti is 3,600 seconds. And then in the exceedance frequency column, if we're using Excel, we can use a Sumifs formula. And the Sumifs formula will sum the values in a certain column based on some defined criteria. So what we can do here is we can sum all of the outcome frequencies in this table where certain criteria are met. The first criteria is that the risk ranking point name has to be equal to control room. The second criteria is that the thermal radiation level needs to be greater than or equal to the thermal radiation level of interest, in this case 37.5 kilowatts per square meter. And then the final criteria is that the values in the duration column need to be greater than or equal to the exposure time value in the table. So we created that Sumifs formula. So this is telling us that the exceedance frequency for an exposure time of 1 second for a thermal radiation level of 37.5 kilowatts per square meter is 3.12 × 10⁻³ per year. And then we can copy that formula down for the rest of this table to then get the exceedance frequencies for all of the other exposure times. And then what we can do is we can create a chart like this. So the chart type, the best chart type to use is this one here, a scatter chart with straight lines. And then, but we need to make some edits to this chart to improve the visualization of it. So the horizontal axis, we can format that axis. We need to make it a logarithmic scale. The maximum value we can set to 3600 seconds. The vertical axis, again, needs to be a logarithmic scale. We can set the maximum value to be 0.01. You can also see that the horizontal axis is appearing at the top. So what you can do in Excel is you can set it so that the horizontal axis crosses the vertical axis at 0.0001, like this. We can also add some grid lines as well, like that. So that's our exceedance frequency curve for this level of thermal radiation. We might want to add some axes. So the primary horizontal axis is the exposure time, and the primary vertical axis is the exceedance frequency per year. And then what we can now do is, let's say that we were interested in a thermal radiation level of 25 kilowatts per square meter, then the chart automatically updates. If we're interested in 10 kilowatts per square meter or 5 kilowatts per square meter, then the chart will automatically update. Okay, thank you for listening, and if you have any questions or would like to get in touch, then please email digital@dnvgl.com.